Thank you, Chitra, for this invitation. I think the indications for phakic intraocular lenses for keratoconus are where the keratoconus has stabilized because of the aging or because the cornea has been cross-linked. And it's important that the patient's spectacle corrected visual acuity is good and they are not hooked onto their contact lenses, because the vision that they get is going to be what they get with their glasses. We were initially thinking decentered cones do not do well, and we're only doing it for centered cones. But I'll be alluding to the study we did, and now we feel that decentered cones can also be taken up with certain caveats. There is this two-step approach. First is the stabilization of the cone, stopping progression. For that, we just do collagen cross-linkage. Or otherwise, if there's enough tissue available, there's enough decentration, then we do a collagen cross-linkage with topo-guided PRK. And sometimes it's CXL with Intacs. I'm not going to go into those details. And then once the cornea is stabilized with a manifest refraction, as well as topography is concerned, 6 to 12 months later, if the patient is wanting a visual rehabilitation, then we think of a toric intraocular lens implantation, a phakic intraocular lens implantation. And as you can see over here, this is a situation where there's gross decentation. The best corrected visual acuity is just 618, a significant amount of cylinder. This patient underwent topo-guided PRK with collagen cross-linkage. And what you see subsequently is that the amount of cylinder has gone down and the best corrected visual acuity is 6.9 plus. You have a more regular bow tie now, and it's a more centered cone. This patient would do well with a subsequent phakic IOL implantation. And here, another extreme situation, the cone appears fairly well centered by high refractive error, and best corrected visual acuity with glasses is not that good, 6.12. We went ahead with a Intacs with CXL. I'm not going to show you the procedure. You can see that the cone is much better center. The refractive error has decreased, but the cylinder acceptance has actually gone up from minus 1.5 to 4, and the best corrected visual acuity has improved. This again, if it is remain stable for 6 months to a year, this would be a good indication for doing a subsequent phakic intraocular lens procedure, which is no different from what we do in other cases. So I'm not going to really run through the video. And this is just to show you that this is the way the lens gets centered very well. This is one of our earlier cases. This is actually a iatrogenic keratectasia case, which we did. And you can see the post-operative picture over here with the Intacs and the toric ICL in place. And this was extreme degree of keratoconus, where we did just a single segment with collagen cross-linkage, waited for a period of almost 1 year, and subsequently implanted a toric IPCL for the rehabilitation of this patient. One caveat I would like to add is that because of the central bulge that you have with the keratoconus patients, you should be very wary or very careful about the measurement of the anterior chamber depth. In a normal cornea like this, this is what you get. But when you have a patient with a central keratoconus, you might get a fallacious reading as far as the AC depth is concerned. There might be quite a bit of crowding in the periphery, and we burnt our hands initially. This is a patient who had, you can see, a couple of times we tried to reposition the lens. Basically, it was a sort of an optic capture where the edge of the lens was coming forward. Subsequently, we realized that these lenses have to be made slightly smaller. This is actually a lens exchange I'm doing. The iris atrophy you are seeing there is because of a couple of attempts at repositioning this lens. And this is exactly the same part of the lens that's being implanted, but a smaller size. So there was also a suggestion that you do UVM and try to measure the sulcus to sulcus. But today, and also do an anterior segment OCT, look at the peripheral thickness. But what we have started doing now is to, depending upon the central cone that is there, reduce the size of the lens that we implant by 1 to 2 dimensions, that is by 0.25 to 0.5 millimeters. As far as the challenges are concerned, the post-implant uncorrected visual acuity would be similar to the best spectacle corrected visual acuity, and definitely not better. In case the patient requires contact lenses previously, especially the Rohscale lenses or the scleral contact lenses, for visual rehabilitation, they may not be optimal candidates. It's a difficulty in determining the endpoint of refraction itself in these keratoconus patients. And on high astigmatism, we may need customized lenses, and our Indian companies are able to provide that. And quite often you will be pleasantly surprised that your optometrist has noted a significant refractive error, but the patient appears to be reasonably comfortable subsequent to these procedures. Of course, this is not a rule, but you come across these few exceptions. There is a possibility of residual error, should always be explained to these patients. Obviously, it's not refractive accuracy, but debulking of the refractive error that we are looking at. In our retrospective study of 126 eyes, which we have submitted for publication, the toric ICL and toric IPCLs we implanted after stabilization of keratoconus, when the patients were comfortable, best spectacle corrective visual acuity, 12 of these eyes had intacts performed in them. The minimum follow-up of all these patients for 1 year, you'd see that these patients were slightly older, and the K-max was not in the region of 60, 65, but more moderate 53, 54. And all these patients had had collagen cross-linkage, either with topo-guided PRK or with intacts procedure, and some of them just collagen cross-linkage alone. The post-operative outcome was extremely gratifying in the sense that less than 0.5 diopters of residual error, we are able to achieve in 80% of our eyes, and less than 90% achieved less than 1 diopter of residual refractive error. As far as the efficacy is concerned, almost in all segments, the preoperative, the postoperative corrected distant visual acuity was better than the preoperative visual acuity. As far as gain or loss of lines was concerned, there was just about 10% of patients who lost one line, and just one patient who lost two lines of visual acuity. In all other cases, there was either maintenance of the visual acuity or improvement in the visual acuity. The other outcome measures that we looked in were whether, what about low cylinder and high cylinder, did it make a difference? The toric ICL and toric IPCL, the Indian variation, which we used more often because they could be custom made for high cylinders, and whether centered versus decentered cones. Decentered cones, initially we thought, were contraindications for implanting these phakic intraoc lenses, but there were a group of decentered cones where the patients were happy with the best spectacle corrected visual acuity. We took them up for phakic intraoc lenses, and it was gratifying to see these patients did quite well. Whether it was less than 4 diopters of astigmatism or more than 4 diopters of astigmatism, the results were quite comparable. You can see that all these patients finally had an excellent visual acuity subsequent to the implantation of the lens. As far as whether it was TICL or TIPCL, that is the imported variant or the Indian variant, again, the results were quite comparable. As I mentioned earlier, the frequency of implanting, the Indian variant is a little higher, thankfully so, because it's also more cost effective, simply because we could also get them custom made for extremes of refractive error. And these results are extremely gratifying as far as the patient is concerned. Coming to decentered was a decentered cone. Mind you, when I'm talking about decentered cone, these are patients who are happy with the spectacle correction. We found that in both these segments, again, the results were quite comparable and gratifying. To sum it up, toric phakic intraoc lenses are effective in rehabilitation of carefully selected cases of keratoconus. Thank you so much for your attention.